You're watching Behind the Paws, Wendell Phillips Academy's student-run television broadcasting program, and only news source with all you need to know about sports, announcements, and events taking place around Wildcat Country. Thank you for tuning in, and now, without further ado, here are our hosts.
Welcome to this special edition of Behind the Paws. I'm Savannah.
And I'm Kanisha. The Phillips football team has advanced to the Illinois High School Association State Semifinals.
Woo woo! During this episode, we will meet some of our Wildcat football players. We will also hear news and announcements. So stay tuned to this episode of Behind the Paws.
What's up? It's your boy Nilo. Mom K. Shout out to JDR.
So you want to know what's going on at Phillips High School? Follow the Wendell Phillips Twitter page at AUSLWPAHS to get your Wildcat news.
My name is Jamal Brown. I'm the number one defensive back in the city of Chicago, and I'm a senior.
What are some of your motivations?
Some of my motivations are that the fact that we, us and Simeon, have a great chance of being the first team in city to possibly win a state championship. And another one of my motivations are my coaches. They really motivate me to, you know, strive for greatness and become the best man and football player that I can be.
Hi, welcome back. We're here with our very own number one quarterback, not only in our school, but in the city, Dwayne Collins. Hi, Dwayne.
Good afternoon.
So, could you tell me some things that you do to prepare before every game?
Before every game, me and my teammates and the coaches, we gather in the room, and we always talk about the struggle we had last year and making it far in the state playoffs. So, that motivates us, his motivational speeches. And then go to the locker room, and then I just listen to music and relax until I can perfect my perfection on the field.
What type of music?
Hip-hop music. There's a lot of hip-hop music. People don't know, sometimes I listen to rock and roll music just because the bass and stuff. So, yeah.
I didn't take you as being a rock and roll guy, but what are some things that motivates you?
Knowing that we are CPS school, and most people from the suburban areas, they don't look at CPS schools to be good enough to win the state championship. And then what happened last year, us making it to the quarterfinals was big for us. So we just came back this year and we regrouped and we just got more hungry and we got better. And now we're striving to get the state championship.
Okay. So what are some things that your team does to show unity?
One thing we do in school and out of school, we just make sure that we look out for one another, make sure we good. And we got this rope that we call the brotherhood, and we all make sure that we got the rope and never let go of the rope, because if we let go of the rope, then we let down each other. And that's one thing we don't want to do like we did last year. So we hold on to the rope, and then we get to where we need to be, the championship.
Is it an actual rope that y'all hold on to?
Yeah, it's a the rope long enough for 40 kids to hold at once. So
y'all just
we be next to each other holding the rope.
So if someone drops the rope, then what?
Nobody dropped the rope yet. If someone dropped the rope, that means we know that we don't have a strong brotherhood.
Before the game, I like to do 20 push-ups each hour. Before the game, I like to watch film, see how I'm gonna win the matchup between me and my opponent across the line. And I like to listen to music.
My pre-game ritual is I eat a donut, then I drink a rippet, and then I pray to God. I ask him to bestow his blessings upon me so I could be safe during my game and I won't have any injuries. That our team wins, we defeat our opponent badly, and then we get to our game and get back to home safely, and that's it.
Hello, Wildcats. Our guest today is not only our strong safety, but the number one strong safety in the city, Jamal Brown. Hi, Jamal.
Hello.
So, what are some rituals that your team is doing to show unity?
Well, our coaches, as soon as we clinched our playoff berth for the state playoffs, they did this thing. They are doing this thing where they're not going to cut their beards until we potentially lose in the state playoffs or potentially win the state championship.
Oh, so how is that going? How the beards, are they getting thick?
Oh, yeah. Coach Troy's beard is getting pretty thick. Yeah, their beards are getting pretty thick, I guess. Yeah.
I am excited to play. I'm excited because it's a chance for our football team to make history. Why? I'm excited because we never made it to semifinals, ever. And this is a chance where we could beat Cold City and play in the championship after Thanksgiving.
Wildcats, the big game is Saturday, November 22nd at 3:45 p.m. at Gately Stadium. I'm Kanisha.
And I'm Savannah. See you next time.
And go Wildcats!
Wildcat football players, we will also hear news and announcements. Your finger noise.
You gonna walk off?
And I'm Kanisha. The Phillips football team has it. My bad, I was going too fast.
Three.
I'm not good with this camera stuff.
Are you ready for the game this week?
This has been a 2014 Phillips Wildcats production.